CSMA is an alternate method to reduce collisions or to reduce data loss. This CSMA has the abbreviation carrier sense multiple access. As the name suggests, when multiple wants to access the carrier, they need to sense. They can't just access. Before they access, they need to sense. Let us see what it is. First, whenever any node, if you have the data, then first sense the carrier. You can't just transmit like aloha. Because your data is ready, you can't just send it. First sense the carrier. Sensing means check the carrier. Check the voltage of the carrier channel. Suppose I have a voltmeter. Main is off. If I just take some wire from anywhere and if I connect it to voltmeter and check the voltage, how much it shows? Zero. Because no current is supplying in it. Right? Once I make the main on and I make this switch on with the voltage regulator, we call it as a regulator, that's why. You just keep regulating the voltage and check the voltage by connecting it to voltmeter. There will be a difference. Definitely it will not be zero. A kind of that. You can understand in that way. Before you attempt to send the data, sense the carrier, check the voltage. If it is idle, then definitely you can transmit. Means you found the carrier is idle, voltage is zero. That means nothing else is happening. No data is flowing in that. No electrons flow movement. So you can send. If B means you did not find it as idle, you found some positive voltage. That means something else is happening in it. Then wait. The CSMA defined this simple point. Just check before you transmit. If it is ideal, you can. If it is not, wait. But here the point is, the drawback is, how long to wait? When I should again try sending? First, now I wanted to send, I did check, it is busy. When again I should check? As per your words, I am waiting. But when should be the next term I should do? This is what undefined here. Right? The waiting time is undefined. Defining this waiting time only, we have got three forms of CSMA. Still I am with CSMA, not CSMA CD. I will add it whenever it is required. You don't understand in your own way, please. It is just CSMA. Okay? Waiting time is undefined in this CSMA. Later, we got three forms of CSMA. One, persistent CSMA, non-persistent CSMA, and P-persistent CSMA. What these three are? These three define this waiting time in different ways, like sliding window protocols. three define the waiting time, they also. Similarly, these three also define the waiting time. One persistent CSMA says that wait this much time. What does this mean? Not to send, but to sense. This thin line you should understand. One persistent CSMA says, you keep sensing the carrier, not sending. You keep checking. Now you did check, it is busy. Keep checking it. Whenever it you find it as idle, then you transmit. This is the point. But if this is followed, let us say A, B, C three nodes are there. B is currently using. A and C are following one persistent CSMA. Means they are keep sensing, checking, 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 checking. Means I am observing from this corner, C is observing from the other corner. When B leave this room, B is in this room. Okay, B left the room. So because we both are continuously monitoring, what we both feel, room became vacant. Yes, then what we do, both attempt the transmission at the eight time. Again, what happens? Collision. You got the point. So wait 0 seconds of time means don't wait to sense. If it is busy, however, you are waiting to send. For sending you are waiting, right? Because if it is idle, then you transmit. If it is not idle, however, you are waiting. How long? Until it becomes free. But how do you know it will? It is free? When you sense only, you will know. That is what undefined here. When I should try again, that is undefined. That is defined in one way as one persistent CSMA. There, the first point is same. What? If idle, transmit with a probability of 1. Means if idle means no one else is using it, so you can take the successful transmission rate is 1. That's why it got one persistent CSMA. But whenever it is busy, then you have to keep checking it. In the same way, when some other node also keep checking it, both nodes may feel the channel as idle at a time, right? Multiple nodes may get the channel status as idle at a time. So again, what happens? All try to attempt the channel at a time because they felt it as idle. So again, collision may occur. That's why it is not correct. So wait 0 seconds means what? Keep sensing carrier. We got another non-persistent CSMA. What this non-persistent CSMA says, if it is idle, transmit. The point A is common everywhere. If it is idle, transmit. If it is not idle, then what it says, wait for random amount of time. wait for random amount of time. It is not continuously checking. You wait for some time, then you sense. You wait for some time, then you sense. This is the point. How that random number is chosen? How that random number is chosen? For that, there is a mechanism. Look at the board, please. There are only two stations, A and B. Okay? A has three packets, P1, P2, P3. B also has three packets, PI, PJ, PK. Okay? Now, A and B has the common medium. A is sending the packet, B is also sending the packet 1. A is sending P1, B is sending PI. At a time, collision occurred. Then they should not send immediately. What to do? A should wait for random amount of time. B should wait for random amount of time. How that random number is chosen? Now, A should choose some number from 2 raised to n A should choose some number from 0 to 2 raised to n. B should choose some number from 0 to 2 raised to n. Let me take it as k. Some number. Okay, k I have taken here. Some x. What is x? How many times collision occurred for particular packet? For the packet 1, how many times collision occurred so far? 1 time. So x is equal to 1 for A. How many times collision occurred for PI? How many times? 1. So x is equal to 1 even for B also. That is the PI packet. So A should choose some random number from 0 to 2 power 1 minus 1, which is 0 to 1. That means among 0 and 1, A should choose some random number. B also should choose some random number from 0 to 1. So, what are the possibilities? You tell me. A may choose 0, B also may choose 0. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Right? If A and B both choose 0 as waiting time, that means they are not waiting at all. Both try to attempt the transmission, which means collision. If A choose 0, B choose 1 as waiting time, who is not waiting? A. That means A won the race. So A will send. In this case, B will send. In this case, both are waiting for the same amount of time. Both chosen one as their number. So A is waiting, B is also waiting. So here the channel is idle, after 1 second what happens again? Both attempt to send at a time, again collision occur. For this 1 second or 1 unit time, channel is idle, no one is using it. Because you thought to wait for 1 minute, I thought to wait for 1 minute, channel is idle. Right? So what is the probability of A to win this race? 1 divided by 4. What is the probability of B? 1 divided by 4. What is the probability of collision? 2 divided by 4, 1 by 2, 50% chance is there, right? Now, let us assume A1 in the first attempt. That means what combination we are taking in it? 0, 1. Assumption this is. You can take other assumptions also. Let A won the race. So, A transmitted, which packet successfully? It's P1 successfully. Right? B is waiting for that time. Now B waiting time is over, in that time A sent successfully. Now again A and B. A has now how many packets? Only 2 packets because 1 is sent. B has how many packets? 3 packets. Now A is sending P2. B is sending, which packet B will send? PI at A time. Again collision occur. Now what is K for A? How many times collision occurred for P2? One time only. But how many times collision occurred so far for PI? 2 times, earlier 1 time occurred, now 1 time occurred, right? So A should wait from 0 to 2 power 1 minus 1, B should choose some random number from 0 to 2 square minus 1. So A and B should choose some number and wait for that time. What would be the probabilities, chances? A may choose 0, B may choose 0. 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. These are the combinations possible. If both choose 0, what happens? Collision. When A is choosing 0, B is choosing big number, what happens? B is waiting, A won the race. Isn't it? Now who win the race? B. Now both are waiting for the same time. So channel will be idle for 1 unit, later collision. Now who win the race? A is waiting for 1 unit, B is waiting for 2 units. So after 1 unit, A can send. B will not attempt because B will wait for 2 units. So then A only win the race, A transmits successfully. Now also A. Now what is the probability of A to win this? 5 out of 8 attempts. Probability of B is 1 only. What is the probability of collision? 2 out of 8, which is 1 by 4. Right? Let us do last time so that you will get the clarity. Now again A won the race. Let A won the race again. Means in these 5 combinations, some combination A and B has picked. So A won. A has transmitted what? So A transmit what successfully? P2 successfully. Now what is the scenario? A has how many packets? Only one packet to send. But B still having how many packets? 3 packets. PI, PJ, PK. Now A is sending PK. B will send still PI. At A time, collision occurred. Now A should choose some A, B should choose some A. I have taken X, okay. What is X for A? How many collisions occurred for P3? One collision only. But how many collisions occurred for PI? 3 collisions. So A should choose some number from 0 to 1, B should choose some number from 0 to 7. Right? What are the combinations? 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, and 0, 7. 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, Now you tell me what happens in every scenario. Whenever A has 0 and B value is greater than that, in all these cases A won the game. When B value is less than A, B win the race, isn't it? In all these cases A only win. Means A is waiting for only one unit, B is waiting more. So A only will get the chance. In the other cases, what happens? Collision. So what is the probability of A? Here 7 times, here 6 times. 13 out of 16. Probability of B, 1 upon 16. Probability of collision, 2 by 16, 1 by 8. Right? So you see, round to round, the probability of collision here 50%, in the next round 25%, here it becomes 12.5%. Like this, if it proceeds, at some time collision probability of collision will be 0 or very very less. Next time it becomes 6, next it becomes 3, next it becomes 1, next it becomes 0.5%, right? If you just keep on counting like this. So the probability of collision is happening what? Increasing or decreasing? Decreasing. In what way? Exponentially. First it is 1 by 2, next it is 1 by 2 square, Next it is 1 by 2 cube. Next it is 1 by 2 power 4. So on. So it is decreasing exponentially. But what is the drawback with this? If these cases are happening, A is choosing 0, B is choosing 1, first time, then B's probability is becoming very less, because out of 8, B has only one chance to win. Remaining more chances are for A only. Means if one node win one time, that node only will get more probability to use the channel again and again. So one node need to wait for long time. Yes or no? Here A probability is high. On the other way, B's probability is becoming very less. So what non-persistent CSMA says is, don't wait or don't keep sending or sensing. Whenever you found the collision, one time, first time when you send, collision occurred, then you don't resend immediately. Wait. How long? For a random amount of time. How to decide that random number? In this way, you have to decide this random number. So, in this mechanism, the probability of collision is decreasing exponentially. And is this method you can apply for more than two nodes? More than two nodes, three are there, A, B, C are there. Can you apply? See, just imagine, there are three nodes A, B, C. Like this, in the first attempt, three packets got collided. Then A, 0, 1, B 01, C 01. Combinations you tell me? A, B, C. 01, 01, 01. Combinations? 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 1. 0, 1. 0, 1. You know the combinations, no? You see the collisions. What it is? Collision. This is collision. Collision, right? Here A is winning. But both B and C are doing what? Waiting for same time. Both B and C, after their waiting time is over, they attempt. So again here collision. So this algorithm is not applicable for more than two nodes. It is applicable for only two nodes. That's why this algorithm is called binary, because it is applicable for only two nodes. Because the chance of collision is decreasing exponentially, it is called binary exponential back-off mechanism. So whenever there is a failure attempt, means once collision occurred, while retransmitting, don't retransmit immediately. What to do? Wait for random amount of time and do attempt. This random number is chosen based on binary exponential back off algorithm. Because of this drawback, we have got other P persistent CSMA, which you can think as slotted Aloha plus non-persistent CSMA concept. Slotted Aloha plus non-persistent CSMA. What is slotted Aloha? You need not to give the attempt. You should not give the attempt at any time. What you have to do? Time slots are given. You are given with time slots. You can do the same in your time slot. Only in your time slot you are allowed to choose some random number. Suppose your time slot expired, yes time slot still there, then you only will choose. Suppose the time slots are like this, my time slot is 1, your time slot is 3. Okay, at 0 both we are checking, it is busy or it is idle, both felt idle, sent, collision occurred. Now 1 is my time slot, so immediately my time slot has come, I will choose some random number among those 4, the first attempt. I can choose any number, fine, I have chosen 0, immediately I will send. Because B will not come for the competition, though it come for the competition, I will only win in these two cases, in this case, right? Here I have chosen 1, 0, there is no chance for B, because B time slot is over, at 0 it is attempting, again when it should attempt, at 3, at 3 you choose some random number among 0, 1. The problem here is what? At the same time, you are choosing some number, I am choosing some number. But P persistent CSMA concept is what? You follow the same. Actually here, A don't know that B is there, B don't know that A is there. Why these combinations we have taken? Both are picking the number at A time. But in the P persistent CSMA, same concept, one time collision occurred, 0, 1 mein ek number lo. Second time also collision occurred, 0, 1, 2, 3, you take some number. Third time also collision occurred, 0 to 7, you take some number. Now, in all this, A has no idea that B is also doing the same. B has no idea that A is also doing the same. That's why you got these combinations. But in the P persistent CSMA, my time slot is different, your time slot is different. In my time slot, I got a collision. Then I will pick one number. Do you also pick the same number? It depends on your time slot. If our time slot also match, then this combination. Yes or no? You got a different time slot. You came now, collision occurred, then you will come in your next time slot. Your next time slot is different. Let's say it is at 1 o'clock. Then at 1 o'clock when you come, then algorithm say, okay, now choose some random number. I am already asked at 10 o'clock to choose some random number. But you are asking at a different time. So, this overlapping combinations probability is less. There also there may be collision. It is not that collision is zero. There may be, like how slotted Aloha, collision may be there. But less chance. Similarly, in P persistent CSMA, time slots are allotted. Only in the given time slot any station should attempt. if collision in that attempt, wait random amount of time as non-persistent. But only constraint is you should give the attempt in your time slot, not any time. Only in that time you are allowed to attempt. That's why probability of collision becomes less. This is what CSMA concept. Still CD is not added. It is only CSMA. Carrier sense multiple access. Okay, it is telling not to wait. These two are telling wait for random amount of time with a clause. You wait in your time slot only according to P persistent. You can wait at any time and give the attempt according to non persistent. Copy. You go on with that order. You just go on in this order, copy in this order. After copying, take a small break. We will continue it after the break. Okay? Break.